freeze follows a thaw and rain, and it's really made it difficult to navigate some of the slick walkways.
New at 6, meteorologist Chris Gloninger is live at Water and McKinley in downtown Milwaukee. Chris, with so much ice and cold, it's a challenge to remove.
That's right. Just take a look at the ice here. This is along Water Street. Now, if your property butts up along one of these sidewalks, it's your responsibility oftentimes to keep it clear. And it'll take a lot more than just rock salt to break through this ice.
This is the first time that I've seen this out completely.
National Ace Hardware owner Dave Rotter said ice choppers would normally be found here. Thursday, people sloshed through puddles of slush on 15th and Highland. Now, people gingerly made their way through the ice at the same intersection.
This Saturday compared to last Saturday, how much did sales increase after we saw the thaw and then the reprieve?
Six times.
So six
times as much salt this Saturday as we did last Saturday.
Is that a pretty big number when you break it down?
It's a huge number.
Cities and municipalities know it's more than just a glaze. In some cases, it's inches thick. Waukesha engineering technician Dale Evans said residents need to at least show some kind of effort to work on the ice.
If there is ice out there, we ask that they salt it and keep it clear. If you do not have salt, you can use cat litter, you can use sand, even ashes from a fireplace.
They don't expect you to chop the ice. The city of Milwaukee is also being lenient, asking people just to make an attempt. If you don't at least try in Waukesha, it starts with a warning.
We will come back the next morning, and if it is not done, then I will carry it out and have my contractor come in and we'll send you a bill.
The cost for them to remove and break up the ice, $2 per linear foot. They don't go around patrolling the neighborhoods. They'll respond to a complaint. Oftentimes, both cities have problems with homes undergoing foreclosure. For now, we are reporting live in Milwaukee. Meteorologist Chris Gloninger, WISN 12 News.
All right, thanks, Chris. You know, help.